Hey guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 201. Airtel conducts India's first rural 5G trial with Ericsson. Airtel achieves 200 Mbps in a 20-kilometer coverage range. Previously, Airtel achieved over 1 gigabyte peak 5G speeds during urban trial. The OnePlus 9 and OnePlus 9 Pro are moving away from Hydrogen OS and switching to Color OS in China. Company official confirmed multiple times, "Now we have it on a paper." The designated Weibo account on Color OS announced public beta is now available and OnePlus and Oppo users can sign up to get it. Realme is planning to launch its Realme UI 3.0 based on Android 12 on October 13th globally, and it is also added that Realme GT series smartphones will be the first to get the Realme UI 3.0. Samsung is busy trying to iron out all the bugs in Android 12 before releasing it as stable update. The Korean tech giant has yet another beta version of One UI 4.0 rolling out, and this one comes with some important improvements and fixes. This update has a build version of ZUZ1 and should be available to users who opted into the beta program in China, Germany, India, Poland and South Korea and some parts of US and UK. Owners of Galaxy S21, S21 Plus and S21 Ultra in those countries should be able to download it starting by today. OnePlus 10 Pro may feature a periscope lens with a 5x zoom. This will be the first time that a OnePlus flagship will ship with a periscope sensor. OnePlus could continue its partnership with Hasselblad, and its integration with Oppo should help with the software optimization. Google has announced the Pixel 6 launch date. The company will unveil its new Pixel smartphones on October 19th. The latest Pixel lineup includes a Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro. Nokia T20 tablet has been approved by the Bureau of Indian Standard and it could go official soon. Nokia devices with the model number TA1392 and TS1397 have been approved by the BIS authority. This tablet could be launched in India soon. The Nokia T20 tablet will have a Wi-Fi only and Wi-Fi plus 4G edition, and it is expected to arrive with a 10.36 inch LCD panel, 4GB RAM, 64GB of native storage and a 10W charging support. Moto G31 has appeared on the NCC listing with the model number XT2173-2. The key specifications include a 50-megapixel primary sensor, a 5000mAh battery, Android 11 OS and a physical fingerprint sensor. Moto G31 price in India is said to be $210, that is around 15,600 Indian rupees. Following over a week of major market instability stirred by China's ban on crypto activities, the value of Bitcoin on Tuesday rose by 4.35%. The most valued cryptocurrency currently trading at ₹38,15,086, that is roughly around $51,160. This is the first time since August 22, 2021 that the Bitcoin has been able to cross the $50,000 mark. The cryptocurrency has started to show positive recovery results at the beginning of this week itself. On Monday, October 4th, Bitcoin opened trading at ₹36,53,453, that is roughly around $49,285, representing an overall rise in its exchange value after it was priced around ₹34,23,691, that is roughly around $46,082 on Friday, October 1st. Asus India has officially confirmed the launch of Asus 8EZ in India. Asus is yet to confirm the launch date. Asus 8EZ is a non-gaming flagship smartphone from the brand, which was launched in the selected markets with Android 11 OS. Apple is working on a new Apple Silicon chipset M1X. These devices were expected to get launched in the past couple of months but have been delayed because of the production issues. And now Apple is gearing up to launch its new MacBook Pro laptops powered by M1X chipset later this month on October 2021. Facebook servers are down for several users around the world last night. Facebook-owned services like Instagram, WhatsApp and Messenger are also down for the users. This issue was fixed after 6 hours of the outage. The flagship sale of Flipkart was expected to boost sales of truckload of products, and it seems to have started showing early trends. It comes as a delight for Apple as Flipkart claims that around 2 lakh units of iPhone 12 series have been sold since the beginning of the sale on October 3rd. iPhone 14 Pro models are likely to get a maximum storage option of 2TB. The vanilla iPhone 12 model might get a bump from the current 512GB storage to 1TB maximum storage variant. This iPhone 12 is also expected to get a whole new design and size options. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.